But first, do you have a science lesson today? If not, then do not worry. We have got you covered. Nina met up with Big Manny, the science expert with millions of followers on social media, to take on a veggie experiment. Intrigued? Watch this.
Big Manny, thanks so much for joining us here on Newsround. You're all about inspiring the next generation of young people to get into science. But what is it about science that you love so much?
For me, it's the experiments. I just love seeing the power of chemistry. Yeah, all of the different colours that we see, all the bubbles and the fizzing, that's what gets me excited about science.
Well, you're obviously known for all your incredible experiments on TikTok, and we have a little one here. We couldn't go too crazy. Do you want to talk us through it?
Definitely. So right here, yeah, we've got some red cabbage. Now, red cabbage, yeah, it contains something called anthocyanin. This is a pigment that we can use to determine the pH of a solution. So we've got three solutions here. We've got some water, some lemon juice, and we've got some washing up liquid. We're gonna put some of the red cabbage into each solution, and the color that it changes is gonna tell us the pH. So let's start with the water first. So we can see that the water is staying purple. So that's indicating to us that it's neutral. It's neither acidic or alkaline. And the next one we're gonna try now is the lemon juice.
Ooh,
we can see
that's a lovely pink color.
So that pink is indicating to us that it's acidic. Final one we're gonna test, washing up liquid. That's gone a little bit darker than the water.
Yeah.
So that means that that's alkaline. One of the real world applications of pH testing is testing the soil, because if the soil is too acidic or too alkaline, then it could be harmful to the plant.
You've written another book, so the second book in your series, Science is Lit. Just tell me a little bit about it.
Yeah, definitely. So this is a follow-up to my first book. The first one was chemistry-based, and this one is more physics. So there's loads of experiments in there that young people can do at home with their families. I wanted it to be accessible to everyone. So the equipment is things that you can just buy at the supermarket, so everyone can have a go.
If you aren't already busy enough with TikTok and a book, you've also been on the new series of Horrible Science. Just tell us a little bit about what that was like.
Yeah, that was brilliant. Yeah, it was nice to do a little bit of acting.
Am I right in saying that one of the characters was based on you?
Yeah, yeah, character Big Danny. Yeah, he was based on my character. So he says things like, aight, boom, wagwan.
Hey,
what's good, bro?
Big Manny, what's going on, my science, bro? Let me tell you something, yeah? This science from the past is amazing still.
That's facts.
Yeah, it was really amusing to see myself being acted out. Thought I had a twin.
All right, come this bounce, man.
Yeah, let's roll, man.
There was research that found that almost one in five young people feel like science isn't for them. I know that's something that I definitely felt when I was at school. So what would you say to those children?
Science is one of the most important subjects in the world, because out of science we get things like new medicines, new inventions. Yeah, that's why I would encourage young people to follow that path, because they'll be able to contribute a lot to society and solve a lot of issues that we may be facing today.